Greetings, shalom. This is gonna finalize the reasoning on unity and the foundation. And it was never intended to teach. You know, I'm sure most of you already know all this information. You know, just a remembrance to, and I need to focus just on the foundation and build on that. You know, sometimes some forget this and others can remind, and then when those that reminded once forget, they'll be reminded by them that remember at that time. You know, it's a collective effort. It's unity that makes strength, not division. And I'd like to just mention that, you know, even though our ancestors, forefathers did not reach the promised land, there's still much we can keep that they succeeded in establishing. We can keep certain good things that our ancestors left for us to continue and proceed to build on that, you know. But but it must be assured that the foundation is Jesus Christos, right? But anything that our forefathers left already established or half established, you know, that is within the will of the Father in Jesus Christos, and then we can keep that, you know. We can keep some of our roots, you know. One thing I gotta admire, you know, reggae music and all of that for the time that it was what it was supposed to be, there's a lot of unity, a lot of sense of, maybe all the knowledge wasn't there, but the oneness, you know, the impartiality, you know, the togetherness. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I didn't see too much division among colors and nations. It was more of a, it's like the music united everyone, and everyone was for the same cause, although they may not have been going at it the right way, you know, not knowing the foundation. But still, that sense of unity and pride in just accepting our God and Father to be the sole, you know, the sole premise and of our existence. And so we can keep some of that, you know. We can learn from our ancestors, as we can learn that which is positive, and we can learn that which is negative, you know. And they spoke out, and I need to speak out. And so you know, I just wanted to state some of these opinions of I, so that to not confuse, you know, anyone. And so the assumption that I'm some kind of professor or anything, I don't know much, you know. Only that which I'm given by the Father and am able to receive, that is all I know, and I know nothing else but that, you know. So so that being said, another important matter, the Ark of the Covenant. I agree with Rasai Adonis, our brother that loveth I and I. And in supporting, we have to support Africa. We have to show the world that we're going to defend and fight for Africa if necessary, and die if necessary. Because Africa needs to know that Rastafari is for them in whatever small way. You know, we'll get into details regarding that, you know, Jah willing, soon. And then another matter, we got to support our brother, you know, Wendem Yadon. He's in a tough position, I would say. Forgive I beforehand if I'm saying that which I'm not supposed to say, but you know, really listen. I'm not jumping to conclusions, but I sense that to not that he can't handle it. He definitely can, but let's help. You know, let's help. You know, if we don't have seriously important questions, let's not ask them. If because you see, what I think is that, and it's just an opinion, you know, and I'm putting myself in the spot, you know, but I care not, because it's true. I feel it to be true, and it must be said. He loveth I and I so much that we put him in a difficult situation by asking him questions that require, you know, like to be a little tough on on some of the students, on some of I and I. Let's give Jah an opportunity to answer some of these more easier questions, you know, and let's not comment like on negative nonsense, you know. Let's try to support and motivate and help him, because he's helped I and I so much, you know. Because there will be many out there that do these things like slander and lies and false accusations with no proof, and even, you know, defaming the name of those, which is not really our business to be even mentioning, you know. Like that's a little too personal right there, you know. Like you know, when slanderers start to include, you know, personal relationships and so on and so forth, then I and I that do seek to do good and help, you know, we gotta keep that in mind and do our part to support our brother any way we can, you know. I pray that these words are sufficient to express what I'm feeling. And if not, I apologize, and it might confuse some, but understand that I'm not in no way against him and in no way against anyone else in Rastafari. It's just that we got to be a little more compassionate towards the brother, you know, take it easy on him. And it's not to say he cannot handle it, but, you know, there's got to be some resting space and some breathing space, and let's not, you know, let's not saturate him with nonsense, and let's be more supportive, you know. Let's be more encouraging. And I'm not saying we're not, you know, but if we are to a certain extent, let's be even more, you know. We have a great opportunity. In fact, it's almost certain that if we stick to the foundation, we'll reach that promised land, you know. Let's be patient. Let's do everything that we can to make this work, you know. It has to work. And any little thing, it's the small details that count, you know. Believe I when I say that, it's the even things that seem insignificant at the time, it's all of that causes those big leaps, you know, those big jumps from small works to great miracles. You know, we got to handle the smaller things first, the details, and everything, Jah, you know, be it the will of Jah, our Father, in and through His Son, everything will work out accordingly. So, you know, not to get more into that, but, you know, it's just that, you know, understand I, you know, don't confuse I words and don't mix up I words, you know. I didn't prepare any kind of speech or anything to assure that I wouldn't say something that maybe shouldn't have been said, but understand I also that I really care for the brother, you know. Like you know, no one ever introduced Christ to I. Jesus, even. I knew the Father, but you don't know the Father until you know the Son, you know. And I really feel for the brother, and I'd like for all of us to really consider that, and to, not that others don't, but like let's act on it, you know. Let's do what we can, do everything that we can, and even more than we thought possible, you know. His Majesty says that until one puts himself up to more than he can possibly handle, then he'll never know or reach that which he can actually handle, you know. We gotta set our standards beyond what we can even do, that way we'll reach the highest possible, you know. And so be it. So just, and slanderers and liars, you know, I don't even want to deal with you, but it's not fair, you know. He's a good man, and innocent until proven guilty. And, you know, our brother in true strength, he said, bring it on, you know, if you got some evidence, you know. Let's hear your case. No case has been brought forward. There must be none. So, if you open up scripture to Psalm 41, it's to the chief musician, a psalm of David. Blessed is he that considereth the poor, The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. The Lord will preserve him and keep him alive, and he shall be blessed upon the earth. And thou wilt not deliver him to the will of his enemies. The Lord will strengthen him upon the bed of languishing. Thou wilt make all his bed in his sickness, his resting place, you know, in tough times. I said, Lord, be merciful to me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee. Mine enemies speak evil of me. When shall he die, and his name perish? If he come to see me, he speaketh vanity. His heart gathereth iniquity to itself. When he goeth abroad, he telleth it. All that hate me whisper together against me. Against me do they devise my hurt. An evil disease, say they, cleaveth fast to him. And now that he lieth, he shall rise up no more. Now that he's laying down and lieth, he's a liar. All those liars, they shall raise up no more. You know? So continue proceeding. Yea, mine own familiar friend, in whom I trusted, which did eat of my bread, hath lifted up his heel against me. Yeah, I didn't just pick this psalm out for no random reason. It ties into the first video and the lifting up of the heel. So continuing with this, and these also tie into the Rastafari sabbatical study on Deuteronomy RSS number 44. So Devarim. So continuing. But thou, O Lord, be merciful to me, and raise me up, that I may requite them. By this I know that thou favorest me, because mine enemy doth not triumph over me. And as for me, thou upholdest me in mine integrity, and settest me before thy face forever. Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel, from everlasting and to everlasting. Amen. And amen. You know, I know that's necessary to go over such scripture. I know it's kind of boring to just listen to me talk, but it's for a good cause. Well, let me just reference that. So if some of the brethren, sister, wanna study up on RSS 44 a little more, Psalm number 7 is in fact relevant. Psalm 7 is not only speaking, it's Shagayan of David, which he sang to the Lord concerning the words of Cush, the Benjamite. And it speaks on the arrows and the turning of the bow and you know, O my Lord God, in thee do I put trust, my trust. Save me from all them that persecute me, and deliver me, lest he tear my soul like a lion, rending it in pieces while there is none to deliver. O my Lord God, if I have done this, if there be iniquity in my hands, if I have rewarded evil to him that was at peace with me, yea, I have delivered him that without cause is mine enemy. Let the enemy persecute my soul and take it. Yea, let him tread down my life upon the earth and lay mine honor in the dust. Selah. Arise, O Lord, in thine anger. Lift up thyself because of the rage of mine enemies, and await for me to the judgment that thou hast commanded. So shall the congregation of the people compass thee about. For their sakes, therefore, return thou on high. The Lord shall judge the people. Judge me, O Lord, according to my righteousness, and according to mine integrity that is in me. O, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end, but establish the just, for the righteous God trieth the hearts, and reigns. Apologize for the bad pronunciation. Continuing, my defense is of God, which saveth the upright in heart. That verse is very important. Psalm 7. Verse 10, my defense is of God, which saveth the upright in heart. God judgeth the righteous, and God is angry with the wicked every day. If he turn not, he will whet his sword. He hath bent his bow and made it ready. This is kind of relating to Paul at that time, Saul, turning around, you know, because he was going the wrong way. You better hope and pray, says Don Carlos, you know, because tomorrow is another day, you know. So continuing on with that, he hath also prepared for him the instruments of death. He ordained his arrows against the persecutors. Behold, he travaileth with iniquity, and hath conceived the mischief, and brought forth falsehood. He made a pit, and digged it, and is fallen into the ditch which he made. His mischief shall return upon his own head, and his violent dealing shall come down upon his own pate. I will praise the Lord according to his righteousness, and I will sing praise to the name of the Lord Most High. El Elyon. Elyon. Okay, just to... to finish this off, you know, go ahead and take note of Psalm 23, which also has to do with Ethiopia, and Psalm 87, and everything that has been in this tripart video series is related, you know. Maybe I have not been diligent at expressing it, but you know, I too am learning, you know. When thou sittest to eat with a ruler, this is concerning the part of Genesis. And even the supper, the lifting up of the heel. When thou sittest to eat with a ruler, consider diligently what is before thee, and put a knife to thy throat. If thou be a man given to appetite, you know, if you're greedy. Reminds me of that portrait of Da Vinci where supposedly Judas Iscariot, the betrayer, is holding a knife. You know, you should have put that knife to his own throat to kind of quench his thirst, I could say. Be not desirous of his dainties, for they are deceitful meat. Labor not to be rich. Cease from thine own wisdom. Wilt thou set thine eyes upon that which is not? For riches certainly make themselves wings. They fly away as an eagle towards heaven. Eat thou not the bread of him that hath an evil eye, neither desire thou his dainty meats. For as he thinketh is his heart, so is he. Eat and drink, saith he to thee, but his heart is not with thee. You know, we gotta be diligent to know what to eat and what not to eat. And let's eat of the tree of life and not eat of any other thing. You know, let's eat the flesh of Jesus Christos and drink his blood. The morsel which thou hast eaten, shalt thou vomit up and lose thy sweet words. Speak not in the ears of a fool, for he will despise the wisdom of thy words. Remove not the old landmark. This is regarding Ethiopia. Remove not the old landmark, and enter not into the fields of the fatherless. We have a father, you know? And we know that we are of the Father. So we go to the Father. You know? For their Redeemer is mighty, even Haile Selassie, you know, the power of the Trinity, the King of Kings of Ethiopia, elect of God. He shall plead their cause with thee, even Jesus Christos shall be an advocate to the Father, to us, of us. Apply thine heart into instruction, listen to the instruction of our Father, and that is to do the will, to keep the law of our mother. And thine ears, I may have confused that. Forgive, I correct that, if so. And thine ears to the words of knowledge, the word of the Almighty, the Logos, the word since the beginning. Withhold not correction from the child, for if thou beatest him with a rod, he shall not die. You know, these words, some of the words I have spoken, or maybe even Rasai Adonis has spoken, may have hurt few, but they will not kill the child, you know. I too am a child. If even that, you know, but it will correct I and I, you know, and we shall not die through correction, through the rod of correction, the staff of the Almighty, you know. Thou shalt beat him with the rod, and shalt deliver his soul from hell. My son, if thine heart be wise, my heart shall rejoice, even mine. If my son's, you know, basically if my son's heart is wise, our father will rejoice, you know. Yea, my reins shall rejoice when thy lips speak right things, you know. So we must utter that which is true and exact, so that our father and his son be joyful, because we have spoken the right things, you know. Let not thy heart envy sinners, but be thou in the fear of the Lord all the day long. For surely there is an end, and thine expectation shall not be cut off, that thy measure, you know, thy estimate. Hear thou, my son, and be wise, and guide thine heart in the way. Be not among winebibbers, among riotous eaters of flesh. For the drunkard and the glutton shall come to poverty, and drowsiness shall clothe a man with rags. Hearken to thy father that begot thee, not our fleshy father, but rather our father that art in heaven, that begot us, you know. And despise not thy mother when she is old, you know. Keep the law, keep the Old Testament as well. Buy the truth and sell it not. Also wisdom and instruction and understanding. This one, I think this one's a perfect like advertisement for the Lion of Judah Society. It'd be perfect. Check it out. Let me go over this again. Let's pass over this again. Buy the truth, you know. We gotta buy the truth, you know. Truth is expensive, you could say. And sell it not. Also wisdom and instruction and understanding. You know, our brother is constantly telling us to invest on our education, and we must. The father of the righteous shall greatly rejoice, and he that begetteth a wise child shall have joy of him. Thy father and thy mother shall be glad, and she that bare thee shall rejoice, Ethiopia even. My son, give me thine heart, and let thine eyes observe my ways, for a whore is a deep ditch, and a strange woman is a narrow pit. She also lieth in wait as for a prey, and increaseth the transgression among men. Who hath woe? Who hath sorrow? Who hath contentions? Who hath babbling? Who hath wounds without cause? Who hath redness of eyes? They that tarry long at the wine, they that go to seek mixed wine. Look not thou upon the wine when it is red, when it giveth his color in the cup, when it moveth itself aright. Look not thou upon the wine when it is red, when it giveth his color in the cup, when it moveth itself aright. At the last it biteth like a serpent, and stingeth like a ladder. Thine eyes shall behold strange women, and thine heart shall utter perverse things. Yea, thou shalt be as he that lieth down in the midst of the sea, or as he that lieth upon the top of a mast. They have stricken me, shalt thou say, and I was not sick. They have beaten me, and I felt it not. When shall I awake? I will seek it yet again. You know, it's to say, you know, like, let's not go after good-looking things and stuff like that. At the end, they'll bite us, you know. Look not for the color, even, of the wine. You know, it's like, I may not have made the connection. I may have overlooked it, but this connects to the miracle of turning the water into wine. You know, one of the governors or the individual says that that some give the best wine first, but this husbandman has saved the best for last, and that is I and I. You know, that wine, we've been cultivated to produce a good sweet taste, you know. You know, let's end it there. I give thanks for those who have went through all videos, you know, and even if just one or just a portion, you know. But you know, I pray it be the will of the Father that many receive this, and if I have misinterpreted the word of truth. I fear not to admit to it, you know, let I know. And this I'll ask as a favor. I'd like to ask everyone that is truly interested in Rastafari to help I out, in the sense that to communicate, you know, if I said something that is not the case, let I know and I'll correct it. I fear not the rod of correction. It only sting for but a while, but it'll fade away. It'll not be an error, rather just a simple mistake that would, could, and can be, and will be corrected. And participation, you know, to help each other out, so that I can know maybe the things that I'm saying wrong, maybe the things that I was not able to receive that once did receive, be it small, be it big. But to share, you know, I'd like to step into the minds of the brothers and sisters within the society and beyond, you know. I'd like to share some of the, I'd like to be a part of the ideas of whatever it is that ones are thinking, or that they like, that they may not like, you know, because that'll only improve I and I, and you know, and strengthen I and I, and build I and I to a relationship of trust, and only in unity can we progress at a more lively pace, you know. And it is the will of our Father, as well as it should be all of I and I's, to you know, to see the name of our Father set up, established on high, you know, as it is meant to be, is, but let it be proclaimed throughout all, you know, all the earth, the heavens, and beyond. So give thanks first and foremost, you know, to the authority being Jesus Christos, that it may reach the Father, and secondly to all in Rastafari. Shalom until then.